Cristo, un Dios, una iglesia poderosa, a powerful church. Turn to your name and say, you are a powerful, supernatural individual. Amen. Usted camina con poder y sobrenatural porque Dios vive dentro de usted. How many believe that? Because God lives inside of you. You are powerful and you walk in the supernatural. Amen. Presente el asiento este mañana. ¿Cuánto está contento de estar en la casa del Señor? Amén. Aleluya. Yo con gran expectativa estoy esperando este día para gozar con el pueblo de Dios. Amén. Cantar con los cantos. Amén. Y alabar a un Dios que es todopoderoso. Amén. Next Sunday we will be back at our regular schedule at 1 o'clock for all the English congregation. So we will see you back at 1 p.m. in el domingo que viene. Mirar usted a las el servicio a las 10 a.m. y vamos a seguir alabando al Señor. Amén. En el infierno y con el diablo no hay vacaciones. No hay vacaciones. Él tiene un plan para desear su familia, su matrimonio, sus niños. Pero para cristianos solamente nosotros hacer vacaciones espirituales. Porque es calor, limonada, los niños no están en la escuela, so, no, you know, hay un vacación, no es de orar, no es de ir a la iglesia, y constantemente el diablo está atacando a su familia. Amen. The devil never takes a vacation, he never has a day off. His plan stays the same, and that is to destroy your family. But us Christians, we now that it's summertime, we take spiritual vacations, right? It's warm outside. We could drink lemonade. We can go to the lake. We can do all kinds of things. But I want to let you know, let's stay vigilant. Let's stay alert because the enemy is like a lion. Amen. That is looking to kill and destroy each and every one of you. Amen. It is an honor this morning to be able to present Ethan Micah Sabala.
Es un honor en esta mañana para nosotros el poder presentar a nuestro al niño Ethan Zavala.
Amen. To dedicate him to the Lord. If the grandparents are here, if they can make their way up also.
Al Señor en esta mañana a este niño y vamos a pedir a sus abuelos que pasen también, por favor.
Thank the Lord for all the grandparents. Let's give all the grandparents
a big
round of applause.
Y damos gracias a Dios por todos los abuelos.
This is the heritage of your faithfulness. This is the reward.
Esta es una heredad de su fidelidad.
Of your faithfulness, amen. And to see both grandparents here this morning. What a
ambos abuelos aquí en esta mañana.
I'm reminded of two things this morning when
esta
I see,
mañana yo soy recordado de dos cosas.
When I see Ethan.
Cuando miro a nuestro niño Ethan.
And that is, I remember the many years that Sister Stephanie brought her three children all by herself.
Y yo me recuerdo, una de ellas es que me recuerdo que nuestra hermana traía a sus tres niños, ella sola al servicio.
Every service we had during the week, she was here.
Y a cada servicio que teníamos durante la semana, ella estaba aquí.
We had 5 p.m. service on Sunday, she was here.
Los domingos teníamos servicio a las 5 de la tarde y ella estaba aquí.
And when I see those years of raising her children and Brother Bob loving his family and serving the Lord.
Y cuando yo recuerdo todos estos años de nuestros dos hermanos de sirviendo al Señor.
We see God's faithfulness.
Vemos la fidelidad de Dios.
Amen. Brother Adán, Sister Anna, all of the years you've served the Lord.
Nuestro hermano Adán y nuestra hermana Ana, todos sus años que han servido al Señor.
You gave above and beyond for the kingdom of God.
Ustedes dieron más allá para el reino de Dios.
There is no gift card better than a grandchild.
Y no hay ni un regalo más precioso que un niño.
There is no award better than
ni un premio que se iguale
having a grandchild.
Que tener un nieto.
Amen. And so I see God's faithfulness throughout this family.
Así que yo miro la fidelidad de Dios a través de esta familia.
And I see God's promises.
Y miro las promesas de Dios.
I remember in a very dark time.
Acordándome de un tiempo muy oscuro.
The doctors had given Sister Rebecca some very bad reports.
Y los doctores le habían dado a nuestra hermana Rebecca unos reportes muy malos.
And I don't know where we were. I don't know if it was a prayer meeting, choir practice, some kind.
Y no me acuerdo dónde estaba, tal vez en la oración o en la práctica del coro.
And God told me to tell you.
Dios me dijo que le dijera.
Get the nursery ready.
Que preparara su guardería.
Amen. There's a baby coming.
Porque el niño viene.
And years later, God fulfilled that promise.
Y años después, el Señor cumplió su promesa.
So I see God's faithfulness to the grandparents. I see God's faithfulness to His word.
Así que yo miro la fidelidad de Dios a través de los abuelos y en su palabra.
Nothing greater than being able to be fruitful.
Porque no hay nada más grande que el poder ser, el poder traer fruto.
And having our children, and then to be arrows in the hands of Jimmy Jammer. That's here.
Y que nuestros hijos puedan ser flechas.
We were on our way here to church, and I
veníamos
told
en
my
camino
wife,
a casa y le decía a mi esposa, digo a la iglesia.
You know, she's reminding me the name, so I don't forget.
Me estaba recordando el nombre.
I'm always good at saying the wrong names. And,
porque no quería decir el nombre equivocado.
I thought of my father, and he had probably called him Ethan James.
Y pensé de mi padre.
Because everybody's middle name was James when it came to my dad. And if he didn't know your name, he would give you a nickname.
Porque si mi padre no conocía tu nombre, él te daba un sobrenombre.
Yeah. We're so proud of you, Jimmy.
Estamos tan orgullosos de nuestro hermano Jimmy.
We are so proud of you. I declare publicly you are a great husband.
Yo declaro públicamente que tú eres un gran esposo y un hombre de Dios y un padre.
You are. And God has affirmed that.
Y Dios ha confirmado esto.
And you're going to have these beautiful opportunities to walk into that affirmation.
Y él te da.
Can we give a big round of applause?
¿Por qué no le damos un aplauso?
Rebecca, Jimmy, I pray that you leave Ethan one time. That you walk out on him just one time, and that's when God calls you home.
Rebecca y Jimmy, yo pido que ustedes dejen al niño solamente una vez, y es cuando el Señor les llame a su presencia.
That he would be secured.
Que él pueda estar seguro.
That he would have a mom and dad.
Que él pueda tener un padre y una madre.
In his life for the rest of his life.
En su vida por el resto de su vida.
That's what this community needs more than ever, is men to stick to their commitments.
Porque eso es lo que esta comunidad necesita más que nunca, que los hombres se comprometan.
And to be a father.
Y ser padres.
Amen. 1 Samuel chapter 1 and verse 27 said, "For this child, Ethan, Micah Sabala, the Lord hath given me my petition, which I asked of him. And therefore also I have lent him to the Lord." I am giving back Ethan Micah Sabala back to the Lord. And as long as Ethan lives, he shall be lent to the Lord, for he is not ours. We are just good stewards to Ethan. Our children are not ours.
Nuestros hijos no son de nosotros.
They belong to the Lord.
Ellos pertenecen al Señor.
He has given us an opportunity to steward.
Él nos ha dado una oportunidad para guiar
on this life.
En esta vida.
In raising them up.
Y
he's enjoying today's message. He's smiling.
Está disfrutando el día de hoy.
Amen. And today we give Ethan Micah Sabala back to the Lord.
Así que hoy en este día le devolvemos a nuestro hermano Ethan al Señor.
That he would be a prophet amongst his generation.
Para que él pueda ser profeta en medio de su generación.
He would be a great drummer like Jimmy.
Pueda ser un gran hombre como Jimmy.
A great singer like his mother.
y un gran cantante como su madre.
A hard worker like Brother Adán and Sister Anna.
Y alguien que trabaje muy duro como nuestra hermana Ana y nuestro hermano Adán.
And faithful people like Brother Bob and Sister Chilna.
Y fieles como nuestro hermano Bob.
The blessings of the Lord are upon him.
Las bendiciones del Señor están sobre de
I'm going to invite everyone if you could just raise your hands.
Si pudiéramos levantar nuestras manos.
May the Lord bless you, Ethan, and may he keep you. May he keep you from all harm and all danger and all sickness. May the Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee all the days of your life. And the Lord lift up his countenance upon ye and give you peace. For his name shall be placed upon you in the name of Jesus. And from generation to generation, you will continue to serve the Lord, your children after that, the grandchildren after that. For this is a legacy unto the Lord on the Sabalba side and upon the Hernandez side. And we declare that right now in the name of Jesus, that you would fear God, that his name would be upon the wall of your heart. God, that you would keep him and protect him, that he would grow and become healthy. And most important thing, that he would fear you above all things. And we declare right now, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your word that has been promised, has been spoken, and now we are able to hold it in our hands. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we give you the glory, we give you the honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Why don't we just give a big round of applause?
¿Por qué no damos un aplauso bien fuerte?
For Brother Jimmy and Sister Rebecca, who are going to do a fine job. I'm going to invite everyone, if you could just please stand.
Voy a pedir que se ponga de pie,
I want you to extend your hand.
Y quisiera que extendiera sus manos
and
hacia
I want
frente.
You, from your words, I want you to prophesy over Ethan. I want
y
you to say,
que con tus palabras,
you're going to be a mighty man of God. You're going to be. I want you just to start blessing him right now. Can you imagine hundreds of people in this sanctuary blessing Ethan right now in the name of Jesus?
En el nombre de Jesús.
God, what you have blessed, what your name has been placed upon, nothing,
porque lo que tú has bendecido
nothing can separate. And Father, in the name of Jesus, may he never know what it is to come from a divorced home. May he never know what it is to not serve the Lord. May he not know what it is to not feel the presence of God in his home and not to hear his parents speak in other tongues. Father, right now we declare he is stepping into seasons and lives of blessings in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we declare it right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Somebody give God a big round of applause. Amen. And let's shout for a miracle that is in the house. Ethan, Micah, Sabala, God bless you. May the peace of God go with you. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Genesis chapter 24, verse 17 and 20.
Amen. Genesis capítulo 24.
What an amazing! How many ready for barbecue this afternoon? Tomorrow.
¿Están listos para una carne asada esta tarde?
I am. My mother leaned over and she tells me. She says, "Tell the congregation that if they're going to the river or the lake, to make sure their kids have life jackets."
Mi madre se acerca en esta mañana y me dice. Recuérdale a la congregación que si salen al río o al lago, que los niños traigan sus chalecos de salvavidas.
Amen. Lord, pray for those that have lost their life.
Oramos
Amen.
Por aquellos que han perdido
just
su vida.
Weekend, through drowning,
este fin de semana.
A lake or a river, and just you are going to enjoy this weekend with your family. Genesis chapter 24, verse 17 through 20.
Genesis 24, Amen. Capítulo 17.
Yeah, I will read it in English and. Brother Frias, it's there in Spanish. I mean, just keep it in Spanish on the screen. And the servant ran to meet her and said, "Please let me drink a little water from your pitcher." So she said, "Drink, my lord." Then she quickly let her pitcher down to her hand and gave him a drink. And when she had finished giving him a drink, she said, "I will draw water for your camels also." Amen. "I will draw water for your camels also until they have finished drinking." Then she quickly emptied her pitcher into the thorough, ran back to the well to draw water, and drew for all. Everybody say all. Amen. All his camels.
Entonces, el criado corrió hacia ella y dijo, te ruego que me des de beber un poco de agua de tu cántaro. Ella respondió, bebe, señor mío. Y se dio prisa a bajar su cántaro sobre su mano y le dio de beber. Y cuando acabó de darle de beber, dijo, también para tus camellos sacaré agua hasta que acaben de beber.
Amen. I want to preach for a few moments on the subject.
Quisiera predicar por unos momentos en el tema.
Giving more than just a cup of water.
Dando más que un simple vaso de agua.
Amen. Giving more than just a cup of water.
Dando más que un vaso de agua.
You may be seated.
Puede tomar su lugar.
When it was time for Isaac, the son of Abraham,
cuando fue tiempo para Isaac, hijo de Abraham,
to be married,
que fuese casado,
his father sent his servant,
su padre mandó a su siervo,
to find a wife for Isaac,
a encontrar una esposa para Isaac.
Amen. His name was Eleazar.
Y su nombre era Eleazar.
If I was living in the time of Abraham,
si yo estuviese viviendo en el tiempo de Abraham,
he would send me.
Él me hubiese mandado a mí.
Because I'm always trying to hook somebody up.
Porque yo siempre ando tratando de buscarle a alguien, a una persona.
And my wife is always saying, honey, you need to stop.
Y mi esposa siempre me dice, debes dejar de hacer eso.
Amen. And so Abraham's servant went to be a matchmaker.
Así que el siervo de Abraham fue a buscar una pareja.
He went to go find a young lady to be the wife of Isaac.
Fue a buscar una doncella que pudiese ser esposa de Isaac.
And before he went to find this young lady,
y antes de que fuese a buscar esta doncella,
he prayed and asked the Lord to help him in this area of matchmaking.
Él oró al Señor y le pidió ayuda en esta área de encontrar una pareja.
And he said, please send me a girl that will not just give me water, but will also give water to my camels.
Y Eleazar le dijo al Señor, mándame una mujer que no solamente me dé agua, pero que también le dé de beber a mis camellos.
Then I will know this is the sign.
Y entonces yo tendré esto por señal.
Amen. It's amazing how when we do God's work for the kingdom of God,
es impresionante que cuando hacemos el trabajo para el reino de Dios,
we are somebody's answered prayer.
Somos la oración contestada de alguien.
Somebody's been praying.
Alguien ha estado orando.
Send me somebody that can pray.
Mándame a alguien que pueda orar.
Send me somebody that can read me the Bible.
Mándame a alguien que pueda leerme la Biblia.
And when God is nudging at your spirit,
y cuando Dios está conmoviendo en tu espíritu,
to do something for his kingdom,
el hacer algo para su reino,
it's because somebody has been asking for that.
Es porque alguien lo ha estado pidiendo.
Praise the Lord. And so the Bible says that this beautiful young lady by the name of Rebecca.
Y así que la Biblia dice que esta hermosa doncella por nombre de Rebeca,
she came along.
Ella vino.
And asked the servant of Abraham.
Y le preguntó al siervo de Abraham.
If he wanted some water.
Que si él quería agua.
Amen. It was by custom,
porque era una costumbre,
that you offer a cup of water to your guest.
Que tú ofrecieses un vaso de agua a tus invitados.
That is all she had to do.
Eso es todo lo que ella tenía que hacer.
Was to give them a cup of water.
Y era el darles un vaso de agua.
And she would have fulfilled.
Y ella hubiese llenado.
Amen. Out of respect.
De ser respetuosa.
The customs that were required of her.
La costumbre que se requería de ella.
Instead.
Así que entonces,
I'm going to paraphrase.
Lo voy a parafrasear un poco.
She said, and by the way,
ella dijo, pues sabes una cosa,
I'm not only going to give you a cup of water,
no solamente te voy a dar un vaso de agua,
but I'm going to inconvenience myself,
pero yo me voy a incomodar un poco,
for a minimum of 3 to 4 hours,
por un mínimo de 3 o 4 horas,
and I will also give water to your camels,
y también voy a dar agua a a tus camellos.
Amen. Because she didn't just give him the cup of water and walk away.
Porque no le dio simplemente el vaso de agua y se alejó.
You see, this is one of the biggest problems in people walking with God.
Sabes, este es uno de los problemas más grandes de las personas que caminan con Dios.
Is that we're always
es que siempre
serving God.
Estamos sirviendo a Dios
with our minimum,
con lo mínimo,
with the least that we can do,
con lo que menos podamos hacer.
Well, at least I showed up to church.
Oh, pues es que de perdiz voy a la iglesia.
Amen. Well, at least I woke up today.
Ah, pues aunque sea me levanté hoy en la mañana.
And we're always looking how we can just get by with just doing the minimum.
Y siempre estamos buscando cómo pasarla haciendo lo mínimo.
How little can I do and get by with it?
¿Qué es lo menos que yo puedo hacer para pasarla?
Amen. There are many Christians that want to do the minimum.
Hay muchos cristianos que quieren hacer lo mínimo.
And expect God to do the maximum.
Y esperan que Dios haga lo máximo.
Amen. We want to give God $1 and expect Him to give us $100,000.
Queremos darle un dólar a Dios y esperar que nos dé $100,000.
We want to give God 50% of our strength and energy.
Queremos darle a Dios el 50% de nuestra fuerza y energía.
And expect Him to just overflow with blessings from on high.
Y esperar que sus bendiciones sobreabunden de lo alto.
Amen. She gave.
Ella dio.
To Abraham's servant.
Al siervo de Abraham,
a cup of water,
un vaso de agua,
that was required,
que era requerido,
of her,
de ella,
and expected of her.
Y eso se esperaba de ella.
But she didn't stop there.
Pero ella no se detuvo ahí.
And she said,
y ella dijo,
and by the way,
y sabes una cosa,
I will also,
yo también,
water, give water to your camels.
Voy a dar de beber a tus camellos.
Everything changed for her life.
Todo cambió en su vida.
Because she wasn't just going to do what was expected of her.
Porque ella no simplemente iba a hacer lo que era esperado de ella.
But she was going to do and then some.
Pero iba a hacer eso y luego después más allá.
I've come to let AJC know.
Yo quiero dejar a Centro de Júbilo saber.
Prophetically, God is telling this church.
Proféticamente Dios está diciendo a esta iglesia.
We need to stop serving God with just a cup of water.
Debemos dejar de servir a Dios con un vaso de agua.
And we need to get the gallon and say, God.
Y debemos tomar el galón y decir,
I'm not just going to show up to church.
No solamente voy a venir al servicio.
But I'm going to give everything that I got.
Yo voy a dar todo lo que tengo.
I'm not just going to take up an extra seat.
No solamente voy a ocupar una silla.
But I'm going to bless the Lord.
Voy a bendecir
with all my soul and all that's within me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I'm not just going to sit here.
Y no me voy a
Somebody's going to get the gift of the Holy Ghost. Somebody's going to be healed. Somebody's going to be restored. I wonder if there's a Rebecca in the house that said, God, I want to do more than just what's expected of me.
Simplemente es requerido de mí.
Somebody clap your hands and shout with a voice of triumph.
Alguien le aplaude y le da un grito de júbilo.
Come on, somebody. You came to the house of the Lord.
Viniste a la casa de Dios.
But you can give more.
Puedes dar más.
You showed up to work.
Fuiste al trabajo.
But you can do more.
Pero puedes dar más.
You're married.
Tu matrimonio.
But you can do more.
Pero tú puedes hacer más.
You have children.
Tienes hijos.
But you can do more.
Pero puedes hacer más.
The bare minimum.
Lo más mínimo.
Well, I'm just going to do what's expected of me.
Oh, pues yo simplemente voy a hacer lo que se espera de mí.
And that's it.
Y eso es todo.
But God didn't save us.
Pero Dios no nos salvó.
Empower us.
Y nos empoderó.
To just give Him the minimum of talents, strengths, and worship.
Para simplemente dar lo mínimo de nuestros talentos, fuerzas y adoración.
Amen. God is awakening AJC.
Dios está despertando a Centro de Júbilo.
With a desire.
Con un deseo.
To do more than just what is expected.
Para hacer más de lo que es esperado.
Matthew chapter 5 verse 41.
Mateo capítulo 5
says if someone forces you to go 1 mile, go with them 2 miles.
Dice que si alguien te pide que vayas una milla, tú ve 5 millas.
Go the distance.
Ve la distancia.
Go above and beyond.
Ve mucho más allá.
Then what you're doing?
Que lo que estás haciendo.
We got to break.
Debemos de romper.
The level of minimum capacity.
Ese nivel de una capacidad mínima.
In our lives.
En nuestras vidas.
Amen. We got too many people.
Tenemos muchas personas.
Thinking minimums.
Pensando en lo mínimo.
Minimal people.
Gente que piensa en lo mínimo.
Well, ask the question.
Te hacen la pregunta.
What is the least I can do?
¿Qué es lo menos que yo puedo hacer?
What's the least that I can do?
¿Qué es lo menos que yo puedo hacer?
Minimal people.
Gente mínima.
Will show up late to church.
Llegan al servicio tarde.
And be the first ones to leave.
Y son los primeros que se van.
Amen. Minimal people.
Gente mínima.
Will show up too late to work.
Llegan tarde al trabajo.
Give what they're supposed to do.
Hacen lo que tienen que hacer.
Complain about what they're doing.
Se quejan de lo que están haciendo.
And expect a pay raise.
Y esperan un aumento en su salario.
Come on, somebody. Talking behind your boss's back.
Hablando en las espaldas de sus supervisores.
And then wondering why you got laid off.
Y se preguntan por qué fueron descansados.
How many times have you called in sick?
¿Cuántas veces has hablado diciendo que estás enfermo?
How many times did you just give minimal?
¿Cuántas veces diste lo mínimo?
Let me tell you something.
Déjame decirte algo.
Jesus didn't just give us the minimum.
El Señor Jesús no dio simplemente lo mínimo.
He didn't just come as a cute little baby in the manger.
No vino como un simple niño en un pesebre.
But he gave his life.
Pero él dio su vida.
He gave all.
Él dio todo.
On the cross.
En la cruz del Calvario.
So that we can have life.
Para que podamos tener
vida. Yet we come here.
Y podamos estar aquí.
Well, I showed up.
Oh, pues aquí estoy.
Well, I'm here, aren't I?
Pues aquí estoy, ¿no?
And God's saying,
y Dios está diciendo,
okay, you're here.
Okay, ahora que ya
estás
aquí,
but let's give a little bit more.
Vamos a dar un poco más.
Let's activate your faith.
Vamos a activar tu fe.
Because faith without works is dead.
Fe sin obra es muerta.
Amen. We will all give the same amount of energy.
Todos vamos a dar el mismo nivel de energía.
In maintaining our depression or maintaining our victory, we will give the same amount of energy.
En mantener nuestra depresión o nuestra victoria usaremos la misma energía.
If you want to stay in self-pity,
si tú quieres estar ahí en tu lástima,
depression,
en depresión,
in guilt,
y en culpa,
it's going to require the same amount of energy.
Se va a requerir la misma energía de ti
that you need to stay in victory.
Que necesitas para mantener tu victoria.
May you are as excited for God,
que tú estés tan emocionado
as
para
you
Dios.
Give to God.
Que lo que das a Dios.
Amen. I can't serve the Lord because I'm just so sad. And you're using energy and time that you could be giving and serving the kingdom of God.
Pues no puedo servir a Dios porque estoy triste, pero estás usando una energía que puedes usar para servir el reino de Dios.
Amen. Minimal people will not give to the financial part of the kingdom of God.
Gente mínima no dan financieramente al reino de Dios.
Minimal people.
Gente mínima.
Will never volunteer to do nothing unless you get paid for it.
Nunca van a ofrecerse a hacer algo a menos de que les recompensen monetariamente.
Amen. Minimal people.
Gente mínima.
Will only get.
Simplemente dan.
What they put into it.
O simplemente obtienen lo que ellos invierten.
But God is looking.
Pero Dios está buscando.
For faithfulness.
Por la fidelidad.
And the ability to serve above what you have been asked.
Y la habilidad de poder servir más allá de lo que se te es pedido.
Everybody say, and then some.
Todos digan, y un poco más.
Come on, and then some.
Y un poco más.
What are you living with right here? Your cup?
¿Cómo estás viviendo tú? ¿Aquí?
Are you going above and beyond?
¿O estás yendo más allá?
Amen. We preached last week in our English service.
La semana
about Ruth.
Pasada predicamos acerca de Ruth.
How she served Naomi, even when Naomi changed emotionally,
sirvió a Noemí a pesar de que ella había cambiado emocionalmente.
She changed her name to bitter.
Ella se cambió su nombre.
Yet Ruth was willing to serve. She positioned herself for one day miracles.
Pero Ruth le sirvió y se posicionó para obtener su milagro.
Amen. I'll just tell you something real quick. And
déjame decirte algo rápidamente.
If you like it, you like it. If you don't,
si te gusta, está bien. Y si no, pues ni modo.
Why is it the first thing?
¿Por qué es que
that you do when you're going through situations?
¿Por qué es que la primera cosa que tú haces cuando estás pasando por algo
is you take a break?
Es de que te tomas un descanso
on the things of God.
En las cosas de Dios.
You take a break on ministry.
Te tomas un descanso en tu ministerio.
Well, Pastor, I just can't do children's ministry no more. I can't do singing. I can't usher. I'm just going through problems.
Oh, Pastor, pues yo ya no puedo trabajar en el ministerio de la música o con los niños porque tengo muchos problemas.
I can't give a live group no more. I'm just going through some things that just overpowering. Over. So are you going to take a leave of absence at work too?
Así que en su trabajo también se va a tomar unos días.
Are you canceling your gym membership too?
¿O va a cancelar su membresía en el gimnasio
igualmente? Are you going to stop going to the mall too?
¿Va a dejar de ir a las tiendas también?
Come on, these are the moments.
Estos son los momentos.
That when you don't feel like it.
Que cuando tú no lo sientes.
And when the pressure is too much.
Y la presión es demasiada.
You get a gallon of water.
Toma tu galón de agua.
And you start serving the people of God.
Y empieza a servir al pueblo de Dios.
Because that is God setting you up.
Porque eso es el Señor
for something you haven't even seen yet.
Para algo que ni siquiera tú has visto.
I said it's on you.
Oh, porque te digo que
the anointing of God is on you.
La unción de Dios está sobre
ti. Not to take a break.
No te tomes una
not to stop serving the kingdom of God.
No para dejar de servir al reino de Dios.
But to give more.
Pero para dar más.
30 seconds. I dare somebody. Don't give God just a cup of water. You give God everything.
No le
even right
Dios
now.
Tú dale todo a él.
When's the last time you let the Holy Ghost take over you? When's the last time you left this church with a horse voice? When's the last time? Come on, come on.
Vamos.
It's 11:17, sweetie. If you're looking at what time we're going to finish church because it's Memorial Day, I want to let you know there's somebody with a gallon of water that says, I don't care if it's Memorial Day. Jesus is worthy to be praised. Somebody here today needs a breakthrough. And if I can be part of it, I will.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Vamos.
Don't you be religious.
No seas religioso.
Don't you be religious.
No seas religioso.
You push.
Tú empujas.
You give more than what is expected.
Tú da más de lo que es esperado de ti.
Come on. Come on, all that voice that you've been holding up all this service, all this, we can let it out. Come on, at the count of three, everybody give a shout of triumph in this house. One, two, three, shout! Shout! Seek first the kingdom of God. Nothing is more important than what God is asking us
nada
to do.
Nada es más importante que lo que Dios nos está pidiendo hacer.
Come on, church.
Vamos,
now, when's the last time you let the Holy Ghost take over you? When's the last time you came to church with expectancy?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que viniste esperando?
My miracle is in this house. When's the last time you walked into the office?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que entraste a la oficina?
Full of the Holy Ghost.
Llena del Espíritu Santo.
The blessing of the Lord is on this house. The blessing of the Lord is on the blessing. Come on. Woo. Instead of just giving the minimum and expecting maximum results, you gotta push yourself. Why? Because the Holy Ghost has empowered you. He's setting you up to do something great.
Tú debes de dar mucho más allá de lo que es esperado de ti. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Vamos.
Come on, husband.
Vamos, esposo.
Come on, step it up in your marriage.
Debes de ponerte de pie.
You boring, cold soul.
Estás frío.
Can't even have a conversation.
Ni siquiera puedes tener una conversación.
Can't even take your wife for some McDonald's coffee.
O sacar a tu esposa para tomarse un café.
And you wonder why the chili rellenos are soggy.
Y te preguntas por qué los niños están como están.
She's mad.
Está enojada.
Amen. Come on. Your car's waxed.
Tu carro está bien pulido.
Your body's in shape.
Y tu cuerpo está bien.
Your wife hasn't had new pair of shoes since 3 years.
Y tu esposa no ha tenido zapatos nuevos desde quién sabe cuándo.
Come on. You come home sweaty from head to toe.
Llegas a la casa del trabajo todo sudado.
And you sit here like a like just a block of ice.
Y te sientas ahí como un
cuadro. That's called idolatry.
Eso es idolatría.
I said it's called idolatry.
Se le llama idolatría.
I mean, you may be seated.
Puede tomar su lugar.
You got time for everything else.
Porque tienes tiempo para todo lo demás.
In the areas that are important to you, you just give just
y en las áreas que son importantes simplemente das lo mínimo.
Amen. We got time to chismear con todos los hermanas.
We don't have time to gossip with all the sisters.
Pero no tengo tiempo para hablar con nuestros niños.
But we don't have time to speak to our children.
Amen. Somebody just told me that.
Alguien me acaba de decir.
They just went to a basketball game, $240 a ticket.
Y acaban de ir a un partido de basketball y se gastaron $240 en un boleto.
$240 a ticket.
$240 por un boleto.
Yesterday it was $100 a ticket just to watch it on a screen.
Ayer costaba $100 simplemente para verlo en el televisor.
Oh, Lord forbid if we ask you for $20 for offering.
Pero que el Señor nos libre de pedirles una ofrenda de $20.
You wonder why you're barely hanging on.
Y se pregunta por qué apenas la andas haciendo.
One thing I noticed the last two Sundays of each month is always on fire.
Pues he notado que siempre los últimos dos domingos estás encendido.
You know why?
¿Y sabes por qué?
Because there's no money in your bank.
Porque no hay dinero en tu banco.
You spend it all the first 2 weeks.
Ya te lo gastaste todo las primeras dos semanas.
You come to church.
Y vienes a la iglesia.
Walking like a rich man.
Caminando como si estuvieras bien rico.
Last 2 weeks you're holding on to Jesus.
Y las últimas dos semanas estás bien agarrado de
Jesús. Come on, we need to break this thing called poverty.
Debemos de romper esto.
We need to break this thing called just getting by.
Y simplemente estarla pasando.
We need to learn to maximize the areas in our life that are so important.
Debemos de maximizar las áreas en nuestras vidas que son importantes.
Amen. Aleluya. Church, just don't do what's just expected.
Iglesia, no hagas simplemente lo que es esperado.
Just don't do what's on your job description at work.
No hagas lo que simplemente está en tu trabajo.
But people ask of you.
De lo que la gente pide de ti.
Do what's expected and then some.
Haz lo que es esperado de ti y después un poco más.
Amen. My definition of leadership.
Mi definición de liderazgo.
Is leadership is all about initiative.
Es que el liderazgo se trata de tener iniciativa.
Amen. You could have all the influence.
Porque tú puedes tener mucha influencia.
You could be so smart up in here.
Y ser bien inteligente.
And yet never take the initiative to do something.
Pero nunca tú tomas la iniciativa para hacer algo.
And wait till somebody asks you to do it.
Y te esperas a que alguien te pida que lo hagas.
This Abraham's servant just asked for a cup of water.
El siervo de Abraham simplemente pidió un vaso de agua.
But Rebecca
Pero Rebeca
took the initiative.
Tomó la iniciativa.
To say, but I will also feed your camels.
Y decir, pero también le voy a dar de beber a tus camellos.
What she doesn't know is that God is moving upon her.
Lo que ella no sabía era que el Señor se estaba moviendo sobre ella.
Because this is going to be somebody's answered prayer.
Porque esta va a ser la oración contestada de alguien.
And this answered prayer is just going to set her up.
Y esta oración contestada la va a posicionar.
To be a princess of a nation. Come on, somebody.
Para ser una princesa.
One in the beginning of the morning, she just came to draw water for her family.
Hallelujah.
By the end of the night, she was going to be a princess to a nation called Israel. I want to tell you, God wants to position you for one day miracles, but you got to get out of the minimum and do something beyond.
Dios te quiere posicionar para obtener tu milagro hoy, pero tienes que estar dispuesto a dar más allá.
Come on, not just because it's a promotion.
No solamente para una promoción.
Not just because you want something from your boss.
O porque tú quieres obtener algo de tus patrones.
But because God is moving upon you.
Pero porque Dios está moviendo sobre de ti.
All of us should write notes to our bosses, say we're praying for you.
Todos nosotros debemos escribir notas a nuestros patrones y decir estamos orando por ti.
Come on, I don't care if he's atheist. I don't care if they're.
No importa que sea ateo o de cualquier otra religión.
If you bought 5 peaches and 1 peach was really good, you save that 1 peach for your boss.
Si tú compraste 5 duraznos y de los 5 solamente uno está bueno, tú debes de guardarlo para tus patrones.
Man. I mean, how many men know how to wash dishes?
¿Cuántos varones saben lavar trastes?
Amen. Wash dishes.
Laven los trastes.
You know, if something comes in your mind like wash dishes, wash it. You know what? Because your wife probably said, I had enough. If I got to wash these dishes, I'm done. This marriage is over. Because, you know, it's always those little things that just breaks the marriage into, you know. And so God's just saying, boy, you better step up and wash those dishes. It's going to be Armageddon tonight if you don't. And so when you feel like, man, I need to do something, do it.
Así que si tú sientes el hacer algo, hazlo.
It's setting you up.
Porque te está preparando.
Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, I've been set up.
Voltea a tu vecino.
To be blessed.
Y dile que yo he sido posicionado para ser bendecido.
Turn somebody behind you and say, I've been set up to be blessed.
Yo he sido posicionado para ser bendecido.
But it's what I'm going to give. Come
Pero
on, somebody.
Que yo voy a dar.
That I'm going to be able to enter into the blessing
que
or
voy
not.
A poder entrar a la bendición.
God is setting you up in your job.
Dios te está preparando en
God
tu trabajo.
Is setting you up in this church.
Te está preparando en esta iglesia.
I met our new mayor on Thursday.
Yo voy a tener a alguien nuevo el jueves.
And there was a councilwoman.
Oh, y había una mujer que iba a dar consejo.
I gave her a big hug. I said, "Good to see you."
Y le di un saludo y le dije, "Estoy contento de verte."
Without even knowing, she started prophesying.
Y sin saberlo, ella empezó a profetizar.
She said, "Mayor, have you ever been to HAC?"
Y me dijo que si alguna vez había le dije que si había estado en Centro de Júbilo.
He said, "No." She said, "That's the best place to go."
Y ese es el mejor lugar para ir.
They do this thing called Family Fun Night. It's something you have never seen.
Es algo que nunca has visto.
You need to get there.
Tú debes de ir ahí a ese lugar.
Man, well, the things that this church does.
Ellos deben de ver lo que
and she just started
pastor.
Talking and I've come to let you know
Hoy
church
it's
time that we position ourselves with more
con más
than just what we're doing
que simplemente lo que estamos haciendo.
30 seconds, somebody clap your hands, somebody rejoice, somebody in this house, God is positioning ourselves for change,
posicionando para ser salvos.
Praise God. The problem is we're always waiting for somebody to ask us.
Y lo que está mal es que siempre estamos esperando que alguien nos pida.
I'm not going to do nothing until the boss or the pastor.
No voy a hacer nada hasta que mis supervisores o el pastor me pida.
I'm not going to fold the clothes if my wife doesn't ask me.
No voy a doblar la ropa si mi esposa no me lo pide.
Amen. Amen. Well, I'm going to stop nagging before my husband tells me to stop nagging.
Voy a dejar de quejarme.
Rebecca, before anybody asked her to go the extra mile, she went.
Rebecca, sin que alguien le pidiese, ella fue más allá.
And each camel.
Y cada camello.
They say that Each camel holds around 40 gallons of water.
Dicen que cada que un camello puede tomar hasta 40 galones de agua, un camello.
One cup of water,
un vaso de agua,
versus 400 gallons.
En comparación a 400 galones
of water.
De agua.
Water, 40 gallons for one camel.
40 galones para un camello.
You talk about perspiring.
Y si tú quieres hablar acerca de sudar,
there goes the manicure, the pedicure,
todos esos que se hacen las manos y las,
the hairdo,
y el peinado.
Real quick commercial.
Un comercial rápidamente.
All you girls that are just sleeping in and waiting for a millionaire to come.
Todas esas mujeres que se que les gusta dormir tarde y esperando que un hombre rico venga.
Rebecca wasn't in her little pink pajamas.
Rebecca no estaba ahí en sus pijamas.
She was working.
Ella estaba trabajando.
She was working.
Ella estaba trabajando.
She wasn't cute.
No estaba ahí.
She was working.
Ella estaba trabajando.
Man, I'm going to make some cupcakes for the kids.
Voy a hacer,
I'm going to go above and beyond.
Voy a hacer más allá.
Nobody's asking me to do this, but I'm going to volunteer in this area.
Nadie me pide que haga, pero yo me voy a ofrecer en esta área.
One cup of water versus 400 gallons.
Un vaso de agua en comparación a 400 galones.
Amen. People have been asking me, Pastor.
Y la gente ha preguntado, Pastor.
We should have combined service all summer. I say, you're carnal.
Debemos de tener servicios combinados todo el verano. Y yo les digo, tú eres, so eres carnal.
Three good little songs, good little preaching, and then what? What? Man, this flesh will eat us up so fast.
Porque esta carne nos va a consumir rápidamente.
The moment you entertain self-pity and depression, it's you're on a downward cycle.
Porque en el momento que tú entretienes esa depresión, vas rumbo abajo.
Man. And then some.
Y después un poco más.
You know what's the difference between an athlete and an Olympian?
¿Sabes cuál es la diferencia entre un atleta y alguien que va a las Olimpiadas?
And then some.
Es que el que va a las Olimpiadas hace mucho más.
I just go to part-time practice.
Oh, pues simplemente voy a ir a practicar.
I live practice.
Pero yo
every
vivo
day of my life.
El
my eating,
en
my lifestyle. I go to sleep thinking wrestling. I wake up thinking swimming. I go to sleep thinking. I mean, they go above and it is a lifestyle.
Ellos hacen mucho más allá y es un estilo de vida.
You know what's the difference between somebody that ends in divorce and somebody that is still married?
¿Sabes cuál es la diferencia de alguien que está aún casado o alguien que termina divorciado?
Going above and beyond.
Es que van mucho más allá.
Amen. Those that have backslidden, those that are still serving God, and then some.
Aquellos que se han desviado y aquellos que aún sirven a Dios es porque han hecho más.
When you come to church,
cuando tú vienes a la iglesia,
I'm going to teach you something real quick.
Déjame enseñarte algo rápidamente.
When you come to church,
cuando tú vienes a la iglesia,
just have your hands raised.
Simplemente mantén tus manos
sing
levantadas.
Sing out loud the songs.
Canta fuertemente los cantos que se están cantando.
When the preacher preaches to you,
y cuando el predicador
amen.
Toma notas y di amén.
When the Holy Ghost comes upon you,
y cuando el Espíritu Santo llega sobre ti,
just let it go.
Déjalo.
Come on, somebody. If you feel like dancing, dance.
Si sientes
if you feel like running, run.
Si sientes correr, corre.
I don't care if you're tone deaf. How great is our God? Who cares? Give it all you got and then some.
Y luego aún
man,
más.
I don't care if you sweat.
No importa,
I don't
si
care if your hair goes limp. Let me tell you something. God wants you to give more than just a cup of water.
Dios quiere que des más que un vaso de agua.
I wonder if there's somebody here today.
O quisiera saber si hay alguien aquí.
That says I am not content no more.
Que dice que ya no estoy
with
contento.
Just coming with a cup of water.
Con simplemente dar un vaso de agua.
I want to give it all.
Quiero darlo todo.
Somebody shout with a voice of triumph.
Alguien grita con una voz de victoria.
Come on, somebody shout with a voice of triumph.
Alguien grite con voz de victoria.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When's the last time you danced in the middle of your problem? That's where the blessing is.
La última vez que bailaste en medio de tus problemas, ahí es donde está tu bendición.
Hallelujah. Come on, press through, everybody, press through. Harabo shanda rabak. Come on, press through.
Vamos,
come on. You need to learn if that little chair gets you comfortable, get out on the aisle. Get down to the altar.
Cómodo en esta silla, debes salir.
When you come to church, you give it all you got.
Cuando vienes a la iglesia, tú da todo lo que tienes.
If you feel depressed, if you feel so pretty,
si te sientes deprimido,
pray with somebody.
Ora por alguien.
Yeah. I bet you will feel so much better if you bring a cup of coffee for the pastor.
Yo te aseguro
Sunday.
Que te vas a sentir mejor
you
si traes
good.
Un vaso de café para tu pastor en la mañana.
Amen. I'm just going through problems.
Oh, pues es que estoy pasando por problemas.
You're going through problems?
Estás atravesando problemas.
Okay, we're going to sign you up with Brother Adam to go to Kenya.
Te vamos a inscribir con nuestro hermano Adán para que vayas a África.
Come on.
Vamos.
Oh, you got problems. When's the last time you ate?
Oh, tienes problemas. ¿Cuándo fue la última vez que comiste?
Tortillas and rice. Pues, I mean, that's enough to be content.
Eso es suficiente para estar contento.
Amen. Well, my children are going to hell. Well, go to hell and get them. Stay in prayer.
Haz una oración.
Fight for your family.
Pelea por tu
don't
familia.
Just sit there.
No te sientes
don't
ahí.
Wait for somebody to pump you up.
No busques a alguien para
this
que
is the day that the Lord has
porque
made.
Este es el día que el Señor
I'm going to find a way.
Yo voy a
I got two
el
feet. I got my
yo tengo
mind.
Dos pies
I got my family.
Y mi familia.
I got eternal life.
Yo tengo vida eterna.
I will find a way.
Yo voy a encontrar una manera
to rejoice and be glad.
Para regocijarme y estar contento.
Come on. All throughout this house, raise your hands. All
todos a través de esta casa levantamos nuestras manos.
Come on. When it comes to the church, when it comes
cuando se trata de la iglesia,
to your job,
o tu trabajo,
when it comes to your marriage,
o tu matrimonio.
Go above.
Ve mucho más allá.
Go above and beyond.
Ve mucho más allá.
Pray for your company.
Ora por tu empleo.
Get a burden for your company. The people need the Lord.
Ora por tu empleo porque hay gente que necesita de Dios ahí.
You'd be amazed what a dozen of cookies could change some of the little things.
Porque hay cosas tan pequeñas.
Brother Delgado's Brother Jet Delgado is at home right now. He's battling some physical elements in his life.
Nuestro hermano Delgado se encuentra en su casa batallando con físicamente.
Get his address from his son, Brother Richard. We're praying for you.
Pero
I talked
tome
to your dad
la dirección
this week.
De su hijo y vamos a estar orando por
we're
él.
Believing God.
Creyendo en el Señor.
Even in impossible situations.
En situaciones imposibles.
And by the way, you look good. You keep moving. You keep moving. Brother Flores.
Nuestro hermano Flores.
Brother Flores is there. He's fighting. I've never met somebody.
Yo nunca he conocido a alguien.
Besides my dad.
Aparte de mi padre.
That has a gallon in his hand.
Que tiene un galón en su mano.
Even when he's sick.
Aún cuando está enfermo.
Even when the doctor says everything's failing in his body.
Aún cuando los doctores dicen que todo está fallando en su cuerpo.
This past year.
Este año pasado.
As weak as he is, he would call me and say, Pastor.
Aún en su debilidad, él me hablaba
y me
decía. I called
Sister So-and-so when she's getting operated.
Me decía, Pastor. Hablé con tal hermana porque está atravesando una cirugía.
Keep her in prayer.
Hay que mantenerla en oración.
I think it's justifiable. He could have just a cup.
Yo creo que se le justifica que él simplemente
he
dé un
just
vaso.
Live with just giving a cup.
Y él pudiese verse.
And we would all be satisfied.
Y pudiese haber estado contento con dar un vaso de agua.
But there's more that he can give even in
pero hay
sick
más.
As he is.
Que él puede dar aún en sus circunstancias.
2 weeks ago,
hace dos semanas,
I was going to go visit him.
Fui a visitarle.
Could remain standing. I'm almost done. And he was sitting in his recliner.
Y él estaba sentado ahí en su silla.
He said, "Pastor."
Y él me dijo, "Pastor."
As feeble as his voice was, his body hasn't been able to.
Su voz y su cuerpo estaban débiles. Él no ha podido caminar.
He's limited in his, you know, breathing.
Y en su está limitado en su respirar.
He said, "Pastor, I want to let you know this Thursday I'm starting my life group again."
Y me dijo, "Pastor, te quiero dejar saber que este jueves voy a volver a comenzar mi grupo de vida."
He says, "I want to connect with some people that just they haven't been going to church. They haven't been doing this and they haven't, and so I'm trying to reach out to them." And
dijo, "Me quiero conectar con esas personas que han dejado de ir a la iglesia y quiero hablarles y conectarme con ellos."
What about us that are just completely healthy?
¿Y qué pasa con aquellos que están completamente sanos?
When's the last time you went above and beyond for somebody?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que hiciste mucho más por alguien?
When's the last time 15 minutes overtime in church didn't bother you?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que el quedarte otros 15 minutos en la iglesia no te molestó?
When's the last time being just an hour in the presence of God didn't bother you?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que el estar una hora en la presencia de Dios no te molestó?
When's the last time when your boss says we need to do some overtime, you didn't complain about it?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que tus supervisores te dicen, sabes que tenemos que trabajar un poco más este día, y no
confusion?
Te quejaste?
We got to learn to give more than just a cup.
Debemos de aprender a dar más que un vaso.
Every hand raised.
Toda mano levantada.
Yeah. Come on.
Vamos.
Come on. Do we really have to ask you to give a Bible study? I didn't tell Brother Flores to start a life.
¿Realmente tenemos que pedirte que des un estudio bíblico?
I didn't tell
yo no tengo
him
que decirle
I didn't tell
al hermano
call
Flores.
The brethren. Come on, church.
Vamos, iglesia.
We're daydreaming.
Estamos
it's
soñando.
Like you're here. Somebody could be going to hell right next to you. It wouldn't even faze you. You could be somebody's answered prayer.
Tú puedes ser la oración contestada de alguien.
When you're walking in the store and you just feel impressed, talk to somebody.
Cuando vas de camino
maybe
a la
leading them in prayer. You don't know, they could be on the verge of suicide.
Y sientes algo en tu espíritu, ora por alguien, porque tú no sabes su condición.
We have these encounters all the time.
Porque tenemos estos encuentros todo el tiempo.
My mom will pray for people at the cemetery.
Mi madre ora por personas ahí en el cementerio.
And they'll say, "You are just what we've been asking for."
Y ellos dicen, "Eres exactamente lo que hemos estado esperando."
If we do small things as they were big things, God would do big things as though they were small things.
Si hacemos cosas pequeñas como si fuesen grandes, Dios puede hacer cosas pequeñas grandes.
In the midst of the sweat,
en medio del sudor,
your time and your energy,
y tu tiempo y tu energía.
When we do small things like they are big things, like it matters.
Cuando hacemos cosas pequeñas se convierten en cosas grandes.
Where's Sister Ellie? I thought I saw her. Sister Ellie, when she's up in the balcony. They moved from the East Coast.
Nuestra hermana, ellas se movieron de la costa este.
There's how many? Like 6, 7 of them.
Hay como 6 o 7.
Their year lease is up next month. They need to look for another place. These are single mothers.
Y el lugar donde viven.
Lots of kids.
Ya se va a vencer el contrato.
We need to pray.
Y debemos orar para que ellos puedan encontrar un lugar. ¿Me puedes ayudar a buscar?
Just go above and beyond.
Eso es hacer más allá.
Any rentals, anything in your area, anything. Come on, you feel so good when you're able to look
porque
beyond yourself.
Porque se siente tan bien cuando tú puedes hacer más allá.
Sister Acidia and Brother Tony, they've been under the care of the Espinos.
Tu hermano Tony y nuestra hermana Siria han estado bajo el cargo de nuestros hermanos Espino.
We know that their family situation.
Y sabemos la situación en su familia.
The Espinos have never asked for a dollar, a dime, anything.
Y los hermanos Espinos nunca han pedido dinero.
Let's do our part.
Porque es nuestra parte.
Grocery gift card, a thank you note.
Es dar una tarjeta o.
I'm not even looking at her. I could just see Sister Espino looking at me like, not even going to look that way. But I'm still going to say it. Man, above and beyond, church.
Hacer más allá, iglesia.
There are people that are hurting even in this house.
Porque hay gente que está dolida aún en esta casa.
Single mothers.
Madres solteras.
People that are serving God all by themselves.
Que están sirviendo a Dios solas.
Mothers taking care of mothers.
Madres que están cuidando de sus madres.
Above and beyond.
Más allá.
More than just a cup.
Más que un vaso.
More than just showing up to church.
Más que simplemente le estar en el servicio.
If God is placing a burden in your life,
si Dios ha puesto en tu espíritu una carga,
it's because somebody's praying to God.
Es porque alguien le está orando a él.
Send me somebody.
Mándame a alguien.
Send me a young lady that will feed my camel so I can know, because this is too big of a weight to hook.
Mándame una doncella que le pueda dar de beber a mis camellos, porque esto es una carga muy pesada.
To find a match for Abraham's son.
Para poder encontrar una pareja para el hijo de Abraham.
You are all somebody's answered prayer.
Todos ustedes son la oración contestada.
It's not embarrassing. It's not something that, oh,
no es vergonzoso.
Help is on the way for Sister Damaris.
Porque la ayuda viene en camino.
God's going to reward the Espino. There's so many people.
Hay tantas personas.
Sister Camila, Sister Irma, Sister Betty. So many parents.
Tantos padres.
Mothers raising mothers. And we need to rise up, church.
Iglesia, necesitamos levantarnos.
Pray for them.
Orar por ellos.
Encourage them.
Animarles.
Don't wait for somebody to ask you.
No esperes que alguien te pida.
What is God leading you?
¿Qué es lo que Dios?
What touches you?
Está pidiendo de ti. ¿Qué es lo que te mueve?
I know there are some things that when God moves upon me and I just, you know, overlook or something, it just, there's a weight.
Yo sé que hay ciertas cosas con las cuales el Señor me mueve y en veces.
Every hand raised.
Toda mano levantada.
We can't be a church that just gives a cup.
No podemos estar en la iglesia simplemente dando un vaso de agua. Yo sé que es el verano.
And I know you deserve more time.
Y yo sé que usted merece más tiempo.
But nothing will ever complete you.
Pero nada te va a llenar.
Like the areas that God is asking you to do.
En las áreas
for his kingdom,
que Dios te está pidiendo que tú
on
hagas
his behalf,
en su reino y a favor de él.
For the widowed,
haz más por la viuda,
for the orphans,
y por el huérfano,
for the church,
para la iglesia.
What is God asking you?
¿Qué es lo que Dios está pidiendo?
What is God asking this church?
¿Qué es lo que Dios está pidiendo a esta iglesia?
I tell you, the one thing God is asking this church is.
Déjame decirte una cosa que Dios está pidiendo a esta iglesia.
He's saying, son, take care.
Es que está diciendo, hijo mío, ten cuidado.
Of children, of single mothers.
De los niños,
de madres solteras.
Provide support
for single mothers, single fathers.
O padres solteros.
Church, it is our responsibility. There is injustice that has been done.
Es nuestra responsabilidad porque han sucedido ciertas injusticias.
We need to help.
Debemos ayudar.
We need to do our part.
Hacer nuestra parte.
We're not saved by works.
Porque no somos salvos por obras.
But God has empowered you.
Pero Dios te ha empoderado.
So that he can place a burden on your life so that you can serve.
Para que él pueda poner algo en tu espíritu para que tú puedas servir.
We all have the same energy and we all have the same.
Todos tenemos la misma energía.
What are you going to do with it?
Pero ¿qué vamos a hacer con ella?
I want to end with this, Genesis 24:53.
Quiero terminar con esto en el libro de Génesis.
After she's serving an average of hundreds of gallons of water.
Después de que ella trajo
those camels,
agua para los camellos.
Those camels that she help give water to.
Esos camellos a los cuales ella les dio de beber.
Then the servant brought out jewelry of silver, of gold, and clothing, and gave them to Rebecca, and he also gave precious things to her brother and to her mother, because there are blessings in areas that God has positioned you to serve.
Y sacó el criado vasos de plata y vasos de oro y vestidos, y dio a Rebeca. También dio cosas preciosas a su hermano y a su madre.
There's a blessing in that elderly parent. There's a blessing in a mean boss.
Hay una bendición ahí en tu patrón que es malo.
There's a blessing in your service to the kingdom of God.
Hay una bendición en tu servir en el reino de Dios.
There's blessing for every bologna sandwich that you have given to the homeless.
Hay bendición en toda esa comida que tú has dado a los que no tienen.
There's a blessing every time you've done a good deed.
Una bendición cuando tú has hecho una buena obra.
That God has placed upon your life.
Que Dios ha puesto sobre tu vida.
There's a blessing, Sister Elvira. There's a blessing for starting this bone marrow drive for Sister Kim's husband, who desperately is holding on to life, who needs a transplant. Can you imagine? Is he even 30 yet? Late 20s.
Puedes imaginarte estar en tus
fighting for his life.
A una persona en sus 20 o 30 años peleando por su vida.
In desperate need of a bone marrow transplant. Church, these things that God places upon our heart, there are hidden blessings there.
Iglesia, estas son cosas que Dios pone sobre nosotros porque hay bendiciones ocultas.
And if we would just follow and hear the voice of the Lord.
Y si simplemente puedes oír y seguir la voz de Dios.
Talk to them.
Habla con ellos.
Pray for them.
Ora por ellos.
Love them.
Ámales.
Do something good for them. There were blessings.
Haz algo bueno para ellos. Hay bendiciones.
And God's just telling this congregation.
Dios está diciendo a esta congregación.
He will never overlook.
Que él nunca.
The things that you are doing.
Va a tener por menos.
Because you're following the prompting of His Spirit.
Las cosas que tú estás haciendo.
Rebecca, it's not just you.
Rebecca, porque no es simplemente el
to feed the camels.
Y el que tú te ofrezcas a dar de comer a los camellos.
It's a setup.
Es una posición.
It's a setup. Don't you ever rush God? Don't you ever put God in a cup?
Nunca pongas a Dios en un vaso.
When you could give him a gallon.
Cuando tú puedes darle un galón.
Who wants to give God a gallon?
¿Quién quiere darle a Dios un galón?
Who wants to go home and say, "Man, I gave it all and I feel great"?
¿Quién quiere irse a su casa y decir, "Yo lo di todo y me siento bien"?
Come on, there's some people that could give 4 hours on a Sunday.
Hay personas que pueden dar hasta 4 horas un domingo.
Come on. You could do things for God, and man, and God will restore your energy.
Tú puedes hacer
God
cosas para Dios, y Dios te va a rejuvenecer y dar fuerzas.
Because there are blessings in those hidden places.
Porque hay bendición en esas cosas.
All throughout this house.
Todos en esta casa.
Come on, let's give God more.
Vamos a darle a Dios más.
Than just a cup.
Que simplemente un vaso de agua.
The next 5 minutes, I just want this whole place just to break out in worship.
If you can get out of the aisle, if you want to come to this altar, esta casa de adoración.
Come on, everybody, just
todos
give God worship,
adoración,
and the overflow of your worship.
Y el fluir de tu adoración.
You'll have a love for your company to serve your boss,
vas a
your
tener
spouse,
ese amor para tu
your
compañía,
children,
para servir a tus hijos,
and
tu
the
esposo,
house of God.
Tu esposa y tu familia.
It's the overflow of worship.
Porque es la abundancia de tu adoración.
Don't put God in a box.
No pongas a Dios en una cajita.
Don't just give him a cup.
No simplemente des un vaso.
Come on. If this is the healthiest season that you're in,
si esta es la etapa donde tú estás más sano,
serve God with that health.
Sirve a Dios con esa salud.
Help out.
Ayuda.
Volunteer.
Sé voluntario.
Everything that you do, come on.
Todo lo que tú das,
give it to God.
Dáselo a Dios.
I want to talk real quick.
rápidamente.
Everybody that's 65 and up,
todos los que tienen de 65 años para arriba.
If you are retired,
si ya estás jubilado.
6 days of the week are Saturdays for you.
6 días de la semana son sábados para ustedes.
You got 6 Saturdays and 1 Sunday.
Tienes 6 sábados y un domingo.
Give it more in prayer.
Da más en oración.
Get to this church during the week.
Ven a la iglesia durante la semana.
Pray.
Ora.
Volunteer. Mentor.
Ponte de voluntario para poder aconsejar a alguien.
Man, if anybody should be so on fire for God, or those that are at home, they have no really big, you've already did your responsibility.
Yes.
You could just pray and pray until there's an overflowing of yes. love and joy and the peace of God. Anybody that's under 40, raise your hand.
Alguien que tenga menos de 40 años.
Yeah, under 40. Come on. Give God your energy.
Dale a Dios
Give
tu
God
energía.
Your strength.
Dale a Dios tus fuerzas.
Give it your all. Come on, church.
Dale todo.
Give it your all. When it's
Dale
time
tu
to
todo.
Worship God, give it your all.
Cuando vengas a adorar, da todo.
Help out.
Ayuda.
Volunteer.
Sé voluntario.
Give God your strength and energy.
Dale a Dios tu fuerza y tu energía.
40 between 60. 40 and 60. Where are you at? 40 and 60.
Ahora los que están entre los 40 y 60.
Give people the wisdom that God has placed you through experience.
Da a Dios esa sabiduría que Dios te ha dado a través de tu experiencia.
There is wisdom.
Porque hay sabiduría.
People dedicated long-term prayer and wisdom and the energy coming together. It's a powerful.
Cuando todo esto se une, se vuelve algo poderoso.
We cannot give a cup and expect a well. Because God is expecting us to partner with Him. It's called faith. Faith includes works.
Porque la fe action. Necesita obras.
In the name of Jesus. The next few moments, I want you just to raise your hands.
Por los próximos minutos, I want you to give it all.
Come on, give it,
give
it your all. Just give it.
Y vamos a dar todo.
Come on. Come on. Get out of the aisle.
Si tienes
come
que salir
to this altar.
De la fila.
Come on, give a gallon. Come on, give it all.
Dale todo a él.
Come on, give it all throughout this house. Come on.
Dale todo
use that energy. Use your strength.
Usa esa energía.
Use your time.
Usa tu fuerza.
That you're using to fall into depression.
Usa tu tiempo.
To stay condemned.
Porque tú no.
Use it for the glory of God.
Úsalo para la gloria de Dios.
Come on, Yarabashat. Come on, there it is. Shatarabak.
I give myself away.
Come on, more than just a cup.
Eres más que un
Come
vaso.
On, we're going to give more than just a cup.
Vamos a dar más que un vaso.
Come on, we're going to give more than just a cup.
Vamos a dar más que un vaso.
We're going to give and then some.
Vamos a dar y después vamos a dar un poco más.
We're not just raising up athletes in this house.
Porque no simplemente estamos levantando atletas.
We are raising up Christian Olympians.
Estamos levantando a cristianos olímpicos.
Come on, this is our life.
Esta es nuestra vida.
This is who we are.
Este es quien somos.
Every day of our lives.
Todos los días de nuestras vidas.
Can you give myself away? Oh, give myself away.
Come on, there's Rebeccas all throughout this house.
Vamos, porque hay Rebeccas aquí en esta casa.
God's putting something upon your heart.
Dios está poniendo algo sobre tu corazón.
Come on, it's somebody's prayer.
Es la oración de alguien.
Somebody needs you in their life.
Alguien te necesita en su vida.
Somebody needs you in the intersection of their life.
Alguien necesita que intercedas en su vida.
I give myself away so you can use. Jesus, give myself away.
We speak to all the Timothys in this house. We speak to all Timothys in this house.
A todos los Timoteos en esta casa.
Your father might have rejected you.
Tu padre tal vez te rechazó.
Maybe he died.
O tal vez falleció.
Walked out on you.
O se fue de tu vida.
But there are spiritual mothers that are raising you up.
Madres espirituales.
There is a church that is loving you.
Y te están amando.
And you will be mighty men of God.
Y tú vas a ser un hombre fuerte de
you
Dios.
Will be mighty woman of God.
Tú vas a ser una mujer fuerte de
says
Dios.
The Lord, you will rise up.
El Señor dice, te levantarás.
You will rise up.
O te levantarás.
Now.
En este momento.
Now.
Ahora.
Now.
Ahora.
You are not alone.
Tú no estás solo.
God is with you.
Dios es contigo.
This church is with you.
Esta iglesia es contigo.
Arrabashata yarabaka yarabashata yarabashata yarabaka yarabashata yarabaka
yarabaka yarabaka
yarabaka yarabaka yarabaka
yarabaka yarabaka yarabaka yarabaka
yarabaka. For all you dealing with self-pity and laziness, why don't you go pray for the Sepulveda family? Pray, God, be with them. They're not alone. Why don't you go up with Damaris and help? Come on. You are not going through the worst thing in this life in comparison to what other people. This is not just coming to church. This is being led of the Spirit. This is being led by the power of God.
Me entrego todo a ti. Puedes usarme.
There we go. Be led of the Spirit of the Lord. I want you to go pray for somebody. All throughout this house, I want you to go pray for somebody.
En esta casa yo quisiera que buscases a alguien más.
This is why you need to be connected to the Spirit of the Lord.
Debemos estar conectados al Espíritu de Dios.
Because God is asking.
Porque Dios está pidiendo.
Somebody.
Alguien.
I remember.
Me recuerdo.
My wife and I were early in full-time ministry.
Mi esposa y yo estábamos ejerciendo el ministerio en tiempo
completo. I won't even tell you what we were making.
Y ni siquiera te voy a decir lo que estábamos ganando.
It was a really bad financial time for us.
Era un tiempo muy difícil financieramente.
And you've heard, some have heard about our yard sale. And we got like $1.50 in our yard sale.
Y teníamos ventas en
that,
la,
that night.
Y esa noche,
I was so depressed, so discouraged. I said, I'm
estaba
done.
Tan deprimido y tan desanimado.
I'm young.
Que dije,
I'm extremely young. I could go get a job.
Que dije, sabes, yo estoy joven, puedo ir a agarrar un trabajo.
I don't need a struggle.
No necesito batallar de esta manera.
We don't need to starve.
No necesito pasar hambre.
And in that really dark place.
Y en ese lugar tan oscuro.
While we were praying for a financial miracle.
Mientras que estábamos orando por un milagro financiero.
God placed it upon a sister in this church.
Dios puso sobre el corazón de una hermana de esta iglesia.
With a certain amount, financial amount.
Y con una cantidad financiera.
That next day.
Y ese día siguiente.
She said, around this time, my mother,
mi madre,
who was not converted,
ella me dijo a mí que su madre que no era convertida,
felt led to give you this.
Me dijo que te diera esto.
This is someone that is not a believer at that time.
Y era alguien que no era creyente en ese tiempo.
It was the exact amount for 4 months of rent.
Y era la cantidad exacta para 4 meses de renta.
Church.
Iglesia.
When God is speaking over your life, over somebody,
está hablando sobre tu vida,
to do something,
a través de alguien para que haga algo,
it's God.
Es Dios.
Saying, you be my hands and my feet.
Diciéndote,
I'm going to give you this opportunity
yo te voy a dar esta oportunidad
to join with me. and being a blessing.
Para que seas de bendición.
Kindness.
Porque la caridad.
And sensitivity be upon this house right now.
Y que la sensibilidad esté sobre esta casa en este momento.
There's people that are hurting. There's people that are struggling.
Hay personas que están batallando, dolidas.
In our jobs.
En sus trabajos.
In this church.
En esta iglesia.
You cannot just clock in and clock out.
Porque no puedes simplemente llegar y irte.
We got to be the hands and feet of Christ. Everybody raise your hands.
Debemos ser los pies y manos de Cristo.
And just respond to the Lord. I will.
Y simplemente responde al Señor y di.
I will be sensitive to the
Yo voy a ser sensitivo a ti.
I will give more than just a cup.
Voy a dar más que un vaso.